Good morning.
Good morning.
And happy Easter. Our last time of being able to continue to say happy Easter. Welcome to St. Paul Lutheran Church in beautiful downtown Sarasota. And we are celebrating Ascension Sunday today. Most of our announcements will be during the time when we go back into the church toward the end of service. And so we will continue and make sure everybody has their song sheet and a Holy Communion kit. If you don't have it, please raise a hand and we can make sure you get one. If not, we will continue with our Easter proclamation. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
We continue with the first two verses of our song, A Hymn of Glory, Let Us Sing, that tells the Ascension story. Continue with the dedication of our lending library, prayer cross, and altar table. So if you don't know, our lending library is at the road. The prayer cross is the big cross toward the road. And then our new altar table that you've been taking the communion elements off of. Friends in Christ, today we give thanks to God and we seek God's blessing as we gather to dedicate the lending library, the prayer cross, and the altar table to the praise and glory of God. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray together. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, ruler of the universe. You made the whole earth for your glory. All creation praises you. We lift our voices to join the songs of heaven and earth, of things seen and unseen. You stretched out the heavens like a tent. You divided the day from the night. You appointed times and seasons for work and rest, for tearing down and building up. You blessed your people through all generations and guided them in life and death. Abraham and Sarah, Moses and Miriam, Isaiah and all the prophets, Mary, Mother of our Lord, Peter, James, John, and all the apostles, and all the saints and witnesses in your church of ages past, in whom your Spirit spoke and moved. We give you thanks, O God, as we set apart and dedicate this lending library, the prayer cross, and the altar table to your glory and praise. Grant us faith to know your gracious purpose in all things. Give us joy in them and lead us to the building up of your kingdom through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. The blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with us all. Amen. We'll continue with the spiritual communion prayer, especially for those of you who are at home or on your devices who cannot physically eat and drink of Christ's body and blood. Let us pray. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. We continue with the Holy Communion liturgy on this Ascension Sunday. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, for the glorious resurrection of our Savior Jesus Christ, who enthroned for heaven forever at your right hand, intercedes for us as our great high priest. And so with Mary Magdalene and Peter and all the witnesses of the resurrection, with earth and sea and all their creatures, and with angels and archangels, cherubim and seraphim, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. At this time, please lift up your communion elements. And if you do not have one, raise a hand, an empty hand, and we can get you one. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, Jesus took the cup, gave thanks, gave for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." With his bread and cup, we remember our Lord's Passover from death to life as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Lord, remember us in your love and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The risen Christ invites us to come, eat, and be satisfied. Thanks be to God. Partake your host wafer. This is the body of Christ, given for you. Take and eat. And this is the blood of Christ, given and shed for you. Take and drink. Now may the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in God's grace now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
We continue with verse 5 of our hymn of glory. Let us sing.
Praise to you, let earth accord. Alleluia.
go in peace to continue to worship the Lord as we go into the sanctuary. Remember, you can drop off your song sheet and communion kits in the garbage, and remember to keep your distance as you walk.
Run Debbie over. Wow, that prelude was awesome.
Thank you.
Thank you. Wow, and I heard a lot of people really loved it. Right about here. Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome. Good job. It's all those after.
Praise with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God now and forever.
Almighty God, your blessed Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, ascended far above all heavens, that he might fill all things. Mercifully give us faith to trust that, as he promised, he abides with us on earth to the end of time, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We continue with our scriptures this morning for Ascension Sunday. Thank you, Martha, for being our scripture reader this morning.
Good morning. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles, the first chapter. Luke writes, "In the first book, Theophilus, I wrote about all that Jesus did and taught from the beginning until the day when he was taken up to heaven after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. After his suffering, he presented himself alive to them by many convincing proofs, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While staying with them, he ordered them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait there for the promise of the Father. This, he said, is what you have heard from me. For John baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now. So when they had come together, they asked him, 'Lord, is this the time when you will restore the kingdom to Israel?' He replied, 'It is not for you to know about the times or periods that the Father has set by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth.' When he had said this, as they were watching, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him out of their sight. While he was going and they were gazing up toward heaven, suddenly two men in white robes stood by them. They said, 'Men of Galilee, why do you stand looking up toward heaven? This Jesus who has been taken up from you into heaven will come in the same way as you saw him go into heaven.' Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God." The psalm today is the 47th psalm. Clap your hands, all you peoples. Shout to God with a joyful sound. For the Lord Most High is to be feared, a great king over all the earth, who subdues the peoples under us and the nations under our feet, who chooses our inheritance for us, the pride of Jacob, whom God loves. God has gone up with a shout, the Lord with the sound of the ram's horn. Sing praises to God, sing praises. Sing praises to our King. Sing praises, for God is King of all the earth. Sing praises with a song. God reigns over the nations. God is enthroned on high. The nobles of the peoples have gathered as the people of the God, of the God of Abraham. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God. The third reading is from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians, the first chapter. "I have heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love toward all the saints, and for this reason I do not cease to give thanks for you as I remember you in my prayers. I pray that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation as you come to know him, so that with the eyes of your heart enlightened, you may know what is the hope to which he has called you. What are the riches of his glorious inheritance among the saints? And what is the immeasurable greatness of his power for us who believe, according to the working of his great power? God put this power to work in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him at his right hand in the heavenly places, far above all rule and authority and power and dominion, and above every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the age to come. And he has put all things under his feet and has made him the head over all things for the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in all." Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
We'll continue with special music as Martha gets her different hat on, not just the assistant minister, now the soloist with her viola, looking for time to set herself ready for bed. She'll be playing Be Thou My Vision. Thank you, Margaret. Happy Ascension Sunday. The imagery of Jesus from the end of our gospel today, his hand raised in a blessing, being carried up into heaven, is a favorite imagery of many. When I first saw our statue of Jesus, I believed it to be the arising Jesus blessing his followers. I've imagined when Jesus was raised into heaven, there weren't just clouds surrounding him, but also the sun with our sunburst, like we have. The history of our statue may not quite be as I thought, since according to our history booklet, it reads, the statue recalls Christ's death for our sins, as well as the benediction, come unto me. Our 12-foot statue, made of copper, was designed and executed by Einar Rasmussen, a charter member of St. Paul. The statue was a part of a three-facet design of this area. The main altar, 8 tons of solid Georgia granite, stands on a raised platform, and unique at the time, allows the minister to face the congregation compared to the often found altar against the wall. The pulpit was actually placed behind the altar originally. Anybody here still remember how that was? I know Helen and John and Martha, some of you are here, and probably some of you at home remember that. And then hanging behind the pulpit was the statue. Reverend French, the pastor at the time of the building of the sanctuary, said this arrangement focuses the congregation's attention on the three main facets of the church. The altar, symbolizing humans receiving God's grace, the pulpit, humans receiving God's word, and the statue, symbolizing the Spirit of Christ behind everything. Ephesians says that he has put all things under his feet and has made him overhead over all things for the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in all. We are all literally at Jesus' feet when we are in this sanctuary. He fills all in all in this place. We can experience this fullness of the one who fills all in all with the enormity of this twice life-size statue. We gather as the body of Christ, the church, a family of God in this place, not only physically but also virtually, knowing the promise of Jesus' life, his death, his resurrection, and ascension, that they are for us, and we are called to go forth to be his witnesses. This is a celebration day, Ascension Sunday. Actually, Ascension Day was last Thursday. As we heard in the scripture from Acts, after Jesus' resurrection, he appeared to people, convincing him he was alive for 40 days. The 40th day is when he ascended into heaven. Ascension Day is always the 40th day of Easter, always a Thursday, since Easter is always a Sunday. Jesus said that not many days from the day he ascended, they would be baptized with the Holy Spirit. This baptism of the Holy Spirit we know is Pentecost, and that we will celebrate next week. But today we celebrate Ascension, Jesus' Ascension. We hear about it in both the Gospel of Luke and the sequel to Luke, the book of Acts. Luke and Acts are both written by the same person. Luke tells the story about Jesus' birth, life, death, resurrection, and ascension, and then Acts tells about the Acts of the Apostles, what happened after Jesus' ascension. Our reading from Acts is the connecting words, the transition, the recapping of what has been said in Luke before starting out with the rest of the story of the first apostles of Jesus. I love how Acts starts out, Theophilus. The word could be a name of a person the author is writing to, or it could be a more general meaning, lover of God, or beloved of God. This could be written to us. We could even put our own name in there. The first book, and then think of your name, covers what Jesus began both to do and to teach. It's just the beginning. The book of Acts is the continuation of Jesus' work in the lives of the apostles, which has led us to here and now. Through our continued work, then will lead to next generations. The apostles could have thought that Jesus' ascension was a bad thing. Their teacher, their savior, was leaving and abandoning them into heaven. But Luke says they are rejoicing. Jesus' ascension doesn't mean absence, but rather a way to send the Spirit, to be able to do more than just one human Jesus could do. And I think the apostles started to understand. So they rejoiced. They heard the two men in the white robes ask why they stand looking up to heaven. These two men in white robes are often figured to be Moses and Elijah. Moses and Elijah were with Jesus on the mountain with his transfiguration, and then again at his ascension, all to connect the stories, to show the history and how they are all fulfilled. And the fulfillment of the law with Moses, the prophets with Elijah, and even the Psalms. The psalm today says God will go up with a shout. The psalm today is known as an enthronement psalm. God reigns. God has always been king. If we look at it through our Christian eyes, we can see God ruling the world and lovingly claiming all the world's people through the work of Jesus. The apostles weren't to look into heaven anymore. God wasn't calling them to a supernatural realm to make a difference, but a faith movement on a global scale. It wasn't up there anymore, but rather down here. So they went on their way rejoicing into the temple and into the streets as witnesses of these things. Throughout the season of Easter, we have had the same blessing at the end of our worship service. May our glorious God grant you a spirit of wisdom to know and to love the risen Lord Jesus. We have a resource called Sundays and Seasons that gives us options for most of what we do in worship. It provides prayers and litanies and a blessing. It changes for each season. Different pastors and deacons and lay people put it together each year. It's both online and an actual book. And I've liked this blessing we've had this season, but I never really knew where it came from except for Sundays and Seasons. But as I read our scripture from Ephesians today, I realized the blessing is from Ephesians 1:17. St. Paul writes, "I pray that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation as you come to know him." Our blessing took that verse and took the deeper meaning that was there in the verse that we can't necessarily see very well in our English translation. As a scholar writes, Paul's prayer is that the hope of the gospel, the glory, and the power of the ascended Lord might come to light in the experience of the church as the body of Christ. This prayer is revelatory and relational. Our blessing uses the phrase wisdom to know for the idea of revealing, or even apocalypse, as the verse in its original language says. Apocalypse, we often hear and think of the end of the world, but really it just means knowing, or like a secret being unveiled, and a truth that shines into us from the outside. We can't have this wisdom from ourselves. It's only through the Spirit. And our blessing uses the phrase, love the risen Lord Jesus, to show that relational focus. The verse doesn't just mean as you come to know about Jesus, but rather knowing him personally. The blessing says love, which is deeper than knowing about him. Paul prays that our faith is confirmed and strengthened, not merely by knowing about Jesus, but by using that knowledge as a trampoline to leap over the chasm of unknowing and unbelief into the authenticating embrace and personal, familial knowledge and presence of God. This Ascension Sunday, our last Sunday of the Easter season. It's the last time I will say Happy Easter in worship until 2022. Happy Easter. Thanks be to God. We'll continue with our hymn of the day, Christ Has Made the Sure Foundation, sung by Susie.
Christ has made the sure foundation.
third finger down, for your mercy is great. Amen.
Alive in the risen Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit, we bring our prayers before God, who promises to hear us and answer in steadfast love. You call the whole church on earth to worship and bless you. Empower your church to bear joyful witness to your love made known in Jesus Christ. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. You have fashioned a habitat for all your creatures, and you fill the earth with your glory. Give rain where it is needed and rescue those inundated by floods. Mend what we have torn in the fabric of creation, and replenish and nourish your world. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. In the majesty of your love, you rule the world with justice and mercy. Give those in authority the spirit of your love, so that all who are hungry and poor receive food and resources, and all people flourish and live in peace. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. You heal those who are sick and bind up the brokenhearted. Attend to the cares and needs of the hurting and hopeless in our congregation, community, workplaces, schools, and families, especially those we name now aloud or in our hearts.
Lord, we pray for those on our prayer chain, those suffering from COVID-19, those who have lost loved ones to COVID-19, for healthcare workers and frontline workers, law enforcement officers, the names listed on our community prayer cross, especially Lily.
Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. You have gathered us in this congregation, enlightened our hearts, and given us a share of the immeasurable greatness of your power. Help us love one another, be reconciled where we are divided, and share the riches of your grace with our neighbors. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Loving God, be with our members, especially
Colleen, John Ryan, and Aubrey, Chris, Emily, Henry, and Vivian Savoca.
And our preschool teachers and students, especially
Miss Jamie and Miss Amy, Janae, Henry, and Cora.
Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. In raising Christ from the dead, you put your great power to work in the world. Raise us and all who have died in the faith with Christ. We remember saints in our lives and in our community. Thank you for their gifts among us. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. In the hope of new life in Christ, we raise our prayers to you, trusting in your never-ending goodness and mercy, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
We continue with the singing and signing of the Lord's Prayer by Susie.
Our Lord, have mercy.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen. Our sending song today is, Lord, I lift your name on high. We'll sing it twice, time, two times, three. By Susie. Together, and if there's others that want to help.
on it, and we will really love, and so love you to help, so let me know, and we will get you trained in how it is done here at St. Paul. And don't worry, it's not like those ultra guilds of that sometimes, like, back in the day, that it was scary and people were mean and everything. I know that has happened. Never here, I'm sure. And definitely not now. So if you've had that bad history of ultra guilt, give it another chance, because it's a totally different atmosphere, and we'd love to have you serve. I think those are my announcements, at least for right now. If I remember something, I'll jump in after it.
Good morning.
Good morning.
So just, we have two birthdays this week. Today it's Bruce Warwick, and Wednesday it's Sandy Tuttle. So happy birthday to both of you. We hope you have a blessed day, not only today, but every day. Community Meals gave out 64 meals this past Tuesday, and the food pantry served 51 families yesterday. We'd like to continue to thank all the volunteers who give of their time to keep these things up and running. Pastor Ashley's e-blast this week begins with the fifth reason to pray the Lord's Prayer, and an announcement that next week we will start unison speaking and Holy Communion inside. So there's a lot more too, so be sure to check it out. And don't forget Making Joyful Noise by John Ferreira. It's a short and entertaining video about the hymns for each Sunday. Thank you, John. Some ministry opportunities this week. St. Paul Prayer Zoom titled Talking with God at 11 a.m. on Monday. And also Monday, Hope Seeds meets in the Fellowship Hall from 1 to 3 p.m. So please join us. All are welcome. Community Meal, 5:30 p.m. on Tuesday. Property at 8 a.m. on Wednesday. Bible study at 6 p.m. on Thursday in the Fellowship Hall. And food pantry bagging on Friday at 9:30 a.m. and distribution on Saturday at 9 a.m. Next Sunday is Pentecost Sunday, so be sure to wear red. It symbolizes joy and the fire of the Holy Spirit and commemorates the descent of the Holy Spirit upon the apostles and other followers of Jesus Christ while they were in Jerusalem. And now, some insults I endured while growing up. I'd say he's about one Fruit Loop shy of a full box. The wheel's spinning, but the hamster's asleep. He's got an IQ about room temperature. The gates are down, the lights are flashing, but the train just ain't coming. If you stand up next to him, you can hear the ocean. And as Rodney Dangerfield used to say, I don't get no respect. John Meyer told me that when he first got his new dog, he considered naming her 3 Miles. He said it sounds great to say he walks 3 miles twice a day. I used to read Bedtime's Daughter to make little Melissa fall asleep. Half an hour later, Sue opened the door quietly and asked, "Is anybody asleep?" Melissa asked her, "Yes, finally." Without water, there'd be no life on Earth, because without water, there could be no coffee. The person who thought it was a good idea to put the light switch outside of the bathroom clearly didn't have any siblings.
Thank you, Rick. We'll continue with our dismissal. And remember our signs for Christ is risen indeed, alleluia, the cross, and alleluia. Alleluia, Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. Go in peace. Share the